already live. I want to sit here. I want to see if people are gonna join the live. How much should I sit there? Maybe I should sit, because you know you are showing in the background. Oh, there's one person. One person has come. We are two. I'm not showing. That one is not showing.
Oh.
Outfit of the day. The ass has really grown. How can I show you this? Oh, yeah. The ass has really grown. I'm laughing, but I'm not happy at the same time, you guys. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to another video. So I know it's been a week since I made another video, but don't worry, I'll try as much as possible to be making you these frequent videos, even though I'm at work. Right now I'm at work, and please do not mind the noise in the background, because I'm by the roadside. Ah? Ebu ongelesha huyo kijana. Kuta. You guys, okay, this is yes, I know. Ah, otikanye, anaenda wapi? Ebu mtisarole. There is someone, okay. So you guys, we are about work, and my assistant wants to also come on live, and I hope this internet is not gonna go off. Don't worry, the background, that's guard your belongings. Somebody stole a phone from here, and that is the reason why now we have to tell people to sort of guard their belongings. So you people, so as I said, I'm at work. What? Akusimwite sahi badai. I'm at work. This lady, sorry you guys, we usually goof a lot here at work. I'm with my assistant. She's laughing and obviously making jokes with somebody was passing by, and he wants to come and talk to us, but because I told him I'm still here on live, so we'll call him later on. I don't know what he wants to talk to us about, maybe a secret admirer, I don't know. So where do I start? A lot of things has happened, and that is the reason why I have not been online. Last time I made a video for you guys, I say to you guys that I'm really, really stressed. I had a lot of things going on, but it's fine. It's fine. Life, that is what life is all about. Sometimes... Wow. Ala, unataka kwa nini?
Sinaona nini?
Sorry you guys, a client has just come in. Nataka kutoa kwa nini yake bado ziko sawa? Ebu, let me see this one. They are still okay.
Yeah, I know.
For
Christmas.
So you come the bus next week. Yeah. Christmas is next week.
No, I have to remove them. At least before they can gel, you feel me. You relax.
All right, you guys. I wanted to speak this client off so that she doesn't come. But anyway, I have to continue talking because I have to make this video. I'm already here. So, and I don't want you guys to. Okay, I'll sit here because I don't want to. I don't want to. be disrespectful or to show whatnot. So there is going to be a noise around me because I'm by the road okay, the topic of the video. So the topic of the video is regarding the employer that I had who was manning my staff. He sort of stole from me, you guys. So let me give you guys a little bit of a background story. There was a time, sometime in July or in August, he came and he was asking me, yeah, we have different shades of red. He came and he was asking me, he first of all was like, he has problems because his children have been chased away from school, and he wanted to loan me some money, for me to loan him some money. So I was, at first I was a bit skeptical, because you know, anything to do with money, you never know, somebody might actually ask you for money and never return it. So sometimes I am just cautious. But then I said, you know, I've worked with him since 2019 and he has not done anything awful to me or anything like that, like steal my money, because sometimes some clients gave him money to, I mean, sometimes he took money from the clients, which I always avoid at all costs, because you never know, sometimes people get tempted and they can end up using the money. Guys, can you like the video a little bit? So I want to make this video very fast so that my data doesn't run out on me when I'm still on. So I gave him the money to make the long story short. At first I told him I don't have the money, but he came begging. He came to my house actually unannounced because he know my place, and came here and all that. He came to my house and announced that I had already come. I was already out of the house, I was at work. Then called me while at my gate saying, I'm at your house, and I need your help, la la la. And I was like, who just comes to anybody's house and announced in the daytime? People are going to work, you can't just come and start knocking at my gate. So I had to direct him to my workplace. He came and we spoke, and then he begged me again. I had to give him the money. So I gave him the money. It was like 20,000 Kenya shillings. That's really like, that's very huge amount of money here in Kenya. So I gave it to him, and I remember it was part of my business money, rent, business rent money and all that. But I was just like, he's saying that his children are chased away from school and they are not going to sit for their exams, and I felt sorry for them, okay, for him. And I said, okay, let me just give him, because what can go wrong? So he told me, I will give you by a certain time, and 2 months passed, he never gave me the money. Okay, so I was like, okay, he will never give me the money, because I really tried to get him to give me the money, but he never gave me the money. So I decided to not pay him his salary and just get my money from there, which he was not happy about, because he wanted his salary while owing me that kind of money at the same time. So I had to put my foot down and was like, I'm not paying him. So he was to get paid, I mean, that money was to, within 6 months of his salary, the money would have gotten paid off. So I was like, fine. Then, remember the units, there were some projects that I had finished, and those projects were rented out already. So I had people who had already occupied those units, and there was money. Okay, there was money that I had to send him because he had to install electrical tokens. Because in Kenya we have tokens. You pay as you go, our electricity. So I gave him either it was like 20,000 because it was to provide three units with electricity. So because I'm busy here and I have my things going, I don't always go there, and plus I trust him. So I thought he had already, and you know he's an engineer, he does electrical engineering. So I just was like, fine, he's gonna do it, and I don't have to man him, I don't have to chase after him and whatnot. But you guys, okay, first before that, a couple of months passed, and I felt like his behavior was being a bit strange. Because I had a new client who had occupied one of the units, and I asked him for the contacts of this lady, and he didn't give it to me. So when the time came for paying rent, this lady paid rent, and he insisted that this lady has to give him money in cash. Remember, I have account that money usually goes through. Everybody pays through there. But this guy insisted that he had to be given that money in cash. And I had no idea. Because the lady asked for my number. He never gave it to her. And I also asked for the lady's number, but no, he didn't give it to me. So 2 months passed and I couldn't get contacts of this lady. I didn't get any rent from her. So I had to go there physically, and I had to actually lock her house, because I asked this guy and this guy was not giving me direct and straight answer. So I locked her out of the house and I left her note. So this lady called me and was so upset, because it was at night when I locked the house. When she came back and found the padlock at her gate, she was rightfully so furious, very understandably, simply because she had paid and I had no idea about it. But anywho, after yelling and screaming and threatening to sue me and all that nonsense, which was in her right, because she said that you employed that guy, you should have trusted him, and it's somebody that I also trust because I gave him the money. Your money is with him. And why are you locking my house? So anywho, the lady told me everything that I needed to know. So I had to call that guy. So when I called him, he was just dodging the answers and dodging. And at first I called him, but he was not picking up his phone for 1 week straight. He refused picking up my calls. Then I knew this guy had already taken money from 2 months rent from this lady and pocketed this money. Remember, my money, school fees money, I had already pocketed. And I didn't know that actually the money I gave him for the electrical meters, he also pocketed that money, 20K. So in total, he was pocketing around 60,000 to 65,000. So I didn't know at first for the token meters, I didn't know. I also didn't know for for the school fees that I gave him, I was deducting him from it from his salary. But little did I know that when he refused to pick up my calls, then I knew that this guy had stolen from me. So I decided to show up in his house after so many attempts of trying to get him to pay me back the money. I showed up in his house. Somebody directed me to his house, because remember, I didn't even know where he stayed. Showed up, found him eating. It was at lunchtime. I told him to give me my money, and he said he didn't have the money. So I had gone to the police station already, written a statement and got an OB. And the police told me, go and find out exactly where he lives so that we can arrange for his arrest. So I did exactly as I was told. So when I went back to the police station, I found a very nice OCS, like the boss, police boss. She's a lady. Remember, the rest of the police, the ones who are under her are very crap. They are very much after money. They just want to eat your money so that they can help you. Before you pay them, they don't care. They just be wearing their uniform and carrying big guns for no reason, but they are not very helpful. So when this OCS saw me, because I had camped in that police station for the rest of the day, the OCS called me. Thank God she's my trouble lady. She's a Luo lady. And then I gave her my entire ordeal. And then she told me, give me that guy's phone number. And when she got the phone number, she called this guy, but this guy didn't pick up because it was just ringing. Then after some time, the guy called the OCS. Not knowing it was the OCS was like, I'm so-and-so calling you from this and this place, police station. And there is an accusation here. You have a case to answer. Make yourself available in the police station within 20 minutes. You are needed here. And when he got there, he was asked 1, 2, 3 questions and that he couldn't answer. Obviously, he had stolen from me. Then the OCS just was like, you get inside the cell. You're not leaving until you pay this lady her money. You can't just decide to steal money from people. You can't just decide to do that. And you are a criminal. You have to get in. So he was locked up. And the entire night, of course, he slept in the cell because he refused to pay me. At first, he said he didn't have the money. Remember when he was locked in the cell, he had people who came, and a lot of people came there to try and plead with me because they didn't want the court case to continue and whatnot, la la. And I told them, remember, at this time, I didn't know that he had pocketed the electrical meter money, which was another 20,000. So there was other things that he had pocketed money. So in total, he was owing me like almost 15,000. But I didn't know regarding the meter. It obviously he is owing me more than that. So I quoted the money that he owed me. Those people by gained and ended up paying me less. I ended up having him removed from the police cell and all that. And then after some time, then now I realized that he had already connected the people who are living in the 3 units. He connected them to use electricity directly from the meter, which I'm the one who is paying. So meaning that those people are not paying electricity whatsoever. So no wonder I keep getting high electricity bills. And you know, the tenants, they are just happy that you let them stay in the house without paying electricity. They wouldn't even communicate that with you. So a lot of things had happened. This guy had stolen so much money from me. So when I called him regarding the money that he took from my electricity meters, he said, stop bothering me. That is what he said to me. Stop bothering me. I had already finished with you from the police station. I owe you nothing and whatnot. He just became very rude after that. So that is what was really stressing me. So I decided to let it go. Obviously, I decided to fire him. He's not working for me any longer. I had somebody else now working for me. And yeah, the guy stole from me. Yeah, that's exactly what happened. And even right now, I'm very, very sad about the situation because I had to source for more money to get another electrical meter so that the 3 units can have their own, you know, electrical tokens that I don't have to pay for them. And I also have to pay their bills as they go because I can't tell them to pay for an electricity that, and it's not their fault that you had them be connected directly from the, you know, from your main source, as in a long story, you guys. So anywho, thank God this video has gotten this far simply because I was not expecting my data bundles to even handle a live video. So I'm at work. I don't want to disturb people around here. I need them to be free. And I don't need to make videos here. So I have to end this video over here. And what else I wanted to say? Yeah, this year I'm not doing Vlogmas. Simply because I'm busy. And also Daisy is not at home. And I have very many exciting things coming that I will talk to you guys about in the next video. And keep it here, and thank you for watching. I'll see you on my next live. Have a lovely day. Bye.